Hello everyone, welcome back to another session on C programming. In today's session, we'll understand how values are getting stored in memory space. If you see this example, here I have declared a variable with the name data holder and I am assigning value 33 to this variable. If we execute this program, 4 bytes of memory will be allocated to this variable. To know how 33 will get stored in this variable, first, we need to understand the decimal to binary conversion. By using this decimal to binary conversion, we convert the given decimal value to the binary value. Before we see the actual procedure to convert the given decimal value to a binary value, let's take a step back and understand what is meant by a decimal value and what is a binary value. Decimal values are also known as base 10 values. This is the example of a decimal value. The reason why we are calling it as a base 10 value is, at each and every digit, we can write any value from 0 to 9. So, we have a total of 10 possibilities at each and every digit. That's the reason why we are calling it as base 10. And while reading this value, we won't read it as 341. We collectively read it as 341 because the digit at first position is multiplied with 10 power 0. Which is nothing but 1, and the digit at second position is multiplied with 10, and the digit at third position is multiplied with 100. That's the reason why we call it as units, tens and hundreds. After performing the multiplication, we'll get 3 into 100, 300, and 4 into 10, 40, and 1 into 1, 1. So, collectively, we pronounce it as 341. That's all about decimal values. Now coming to binary values, we call these binary values as a base 2 values because in binary values, at each digit, we have a possibility of two values. That is, either we can store 1 or 0. That's the reason why we call it as a base 2 value. Now, let's see how to convert a decimal value to binary value. To get binary value from a given decimal value, divide this decimal value with 2 repeatedly until you get 1. And at each stage, store the remainder that you got. If you look at this example, here I am dividing this 33 with 2 continuously until I get 1. So 2 16s are 32 and we got 1 as remainder here. So I have written 1 here and 2 8s are 16 and at this case we got 0 as remainder. So I have written 0. Similarly, 2 4s are 8 and 2 2s are 4. In both the cases, we got 0 as remainder and 2 1s are 2. So, finally, we got 1 here. Now, note down the value in reverse order. You will get 100001. This is the equivalent binary value of the decimal value. This value will get stored in computer memory. If you look at this example, here we have used int data type. The variable which is having int data type will get 4 bytes of memory space. So, 4 bytes means 32 bits. So we got 32 bits of memory space. Now, when we convert this decimal value to binary value, we got a total of 6 bits. These 6 bits are sufficient to represent this decimal value. So the 6 bits will be filled up here. And the remaining bits are filled up with zeros. This is how this decimal value 33 is stored in memory space. I hope you are clear about this. Till now, we got to know that after assigning this 33, how it will get stored in the memory space of this variable. Now, when we pass this variable to printf by using %d as a format specifier, printf converts back the binary value in this memory space into the decimal value and it will print it onto the screen. Here, printf follows binary to decimal conversion to convert the decimal value to binary value. Let's see how to do that. This is the binary value of 33. Here, if the bit has 0, then we can say that the bit was unset. And if the bit has 1, then this bit was set. To convert this binary value to a decimal value, first identify at which positions the bits are set. Here, at 0th position, the bit was set, and at 5th position, the bit was set. Now, we have to add this 2 power 0 and 2 power 5 to get decimal value 33 from this binary value. Let's see few more examples of binary to decimal conversion. Here we have a binary value. In this binary value, the bit at 0th position and 3rd position was set. So let's add 2 power 0 plus 2 power 3 to get the equivalent decimal value of this binary value. We got 9 as decimal value. Let me show you in another example. Here the bit at 3rd position was set and at 8th position was set. Let's add 2 power 3 plus 2 power 8 to get the decimal value of this binary value. That's how the decimal values will get converted to binary values when we are storing it in a variable, and again the binary values will get converted back to a decimal value. Hope you understand this session. Thank you for listening. See you later in next session.